Hey everyone, it's Carissa at Sprinkled with Glitter. Thanks for stopping by today. Today I am going to be making some very adorable shaker tags. When I saw the new release from the Essentials by Ellen line for December 2017, I just knew I had to make a shaker tag, and I hadn't used my fuse in a while, so I decided to bring out the fuse tool and fire it up and get it working again. Now here is the party bundle that was kind of put together to coordinate perfectly with the new stamps and dies from the Essentials by Ellen line for 2017. And if you want a closer, more in-depth look at this entire bundle, I will be sure to link a video tutorial that I created last week featuring the Cue the Confetti stamp set and the Confetti Flinger die. So I'll be sure to throw up a card for that. Now, I will be using the Cue the Confetti stamp set here. This has some fun sentiments in it, and it just makes me want to party. And I'll also be using the Yay die set. Now, I love this birthday kind of balloon edge, but I'm going to be using the confetti die from that today. And I'm going to be creating my own confetti, and I'm using some black cardstock, some pink cardstock, and some kind of teal cardstock. So in order to get a good cut, I am going to use my precision base plate because this has a lot of cutting to do. And that precision base plate helps me with dies that are more intricate and that sort of thing, just making sure I get a really good die cut image. I don't always use the precision base plate, but I find for dies like this, it's perfect, or those little really fine sentiment dies. I just prefer to use that in this instance, and I'm not fighting with my plates that are kind of bunged up right now too. So as I die cut this confetti, I'm going to just kind of pop it out into a little clear container that I have here on my desk. If you wanted to separate them out by colors, you could definitely do that with some little jars or containers, but I just decided to mix it all together and just make it easy on myself. So you can see it cuts beautifully. I'm just popping them out with my fingers. Anything that's left in the die, I'm going to pop out with my little piercer tool. And now I'm going to start working on my stamped images. So I'm going to be using the Cue the Confetti and the Toss Me sentiments from this. And I am going to stamp the Toss Me sentiment, it's kind of shaped in a circle, onto this pattern paper here that is a part of that Happy Hooray pattern paper pad from Pebbles. And that's a part of the bundle. And I'm just inking this up in some Versamark ink and stamping it up there in the corner, and I'll pop it out with a circle punch later on. Now I'm coating this in some Wow Super Fine Detail embossing powder in the color Rich Pale Gold. It's one of my favorite gold embossing powders. And any areas that you feel like those fine letters kind of closed up, I just use my piercer and just kind of knock away a piece or two of that embossing powder to kind of open up those letters and make sure that they don't get kind of messed up when you emboss them. Now I'm also stamping the Cue the Confetti sentiment onto this vellum strip here, and I'm stamping it in some VersaFine Onyx Black pigment ink, and then I'm going to coat it in some clear embossing powder. And once I get both of these stamped and the embossing powder put onto my images, I'm going to go ahead and use my heat tool to melt that embossing powder. With the vellum, just keep your heat tool moving and make sure that you don't leave it in one place for too long. So I have that embossed, and that gives me a beautiful black sentiment onto that vellum strip, and I'm now embossing my little gold circle. And then I'm going to pop it out using a 1.5-inch circle punch. Now, I don't have a whole lot of punches left in my stash, but I do use my circle punches from time to time, so they are one of the only punches that I have left. If you don't have a circle punch, you could absolutely use a circle die or hand cut it. Now that that's all punched out and embossed, I'm going to go ahead and just attach it to my vellum strip using some foam adhesive. And this is a part of the release too. And I usually take my dies and I put them into the same envelope as the coordinating stamp set. And the reason I'm showing you that is because then I can use this extra stamp pocket to make my shaker tag. And I'm just gonna trim it down a little bit so that I can save that other piece for another project. And I am going to cut off the seams and just leave one seam down there at the bottom, so I'm not fighting with keeping these two pieces of plastic together. Now I'm using a tag shape die from Mama Elephant in order to create my tag. And I am going to use some painter's tape to keep that in place. And I've just placed it on the inside of the die because I'm going to go around the outside of the die with my fuse tool. Now, when you're using the fuse tool, you want to make sure that it has plenty of time to heat up. So I plug this in, I don't know, 10, 15, 20 minutes prior to me fusing things closed, and I just let it get good and hot. And you can see I'm going at a pretty slow pace in order to allow those two pieces of plastic to melt and fuse together. Now, I've worked my way around like three sides of this tag if it were a rectangle, but there's a lot more sides because it's a tag and not a rectangle. And I've left the top open for now. And had I not fused that upper right-hand kind of corner where it cuts in, I would have been able to slip a gift card inside of this tag. So I wanted to show you that that's definitely an option and a fun way to give a gift tag for a birthday or during this holiday season. They would have to cut it open to get to the gift tag, and then all that confetti would go everywhere. So that would be a fun idea, and I think maybe I will do that for my nieces and nephews this year. And now I'm going to fill my shaker tag with the confetti that I created using that Yay die set. And I'm also going to put some gold flat confetti from Pretty Pink Posh inside here as well, just to add a little bit of sparkle. And then I'm also adding some of these sequins. These are like a sesame seed shaped sequin that came in the party bundle. And these are kind of multicolored and iridescent. And I put some of those in there as well. So I have this nice mix of different colors and shine. And then I am going to go ahead and fuse my top closed so that it's all sealed up inside of that plastic. And you can see I'm working on that board there. Sometimes I use a clipboard instead, like a wood clipboard, so that I don't burn my mat, my crafting mat that I have, that black mat under there. Very important. This does get really hot. It will melt your mat. I mean, I've done it before. So once I have that done, I'm going to just go ahead and lift this up. I'm going to remove the die, and then I'm going to trim around these straighter edges using my trimmer here. And then along the bottom where it has kind of that banner shape or that fishtail shape, I'm just going to use my scissors to trim that up. And this trims up really easily and nicely. So now I have my vellum sentiment panel here, and I'm just cutting that into a banner shape as well by cutting a slit in the center of the strip and then cutting from each corner to that center slit, and that creates a perfect banner end. And before I attach this onto my shaker tag here, I thought it would be fun to have a layer or a messy nest of this gold thread behind the sentiment strip as well. So I'm just wrapping it around my fingers several times. I'm placing it on top of my tag there and just kind of getting it just right. You know, there is just right messy, right? I mean, you can't have it look too neat. You can't have it look too messy. So you got to get it just right. And when you do, you can go ahead and attach your sentiment strip on top of it. I am going to use the foam adhesive that's on the back of the sentiment strip to kind of just sandwich it between that sentiment strip and the tag. Now to finish my tag off, I just took some black and white baker's twine and created a little bow. And I'm just gonna attach my bow using some Ranger collage medium in the matte finish. I'm just gonna put a generous little drop there at the top, position my bow into that, and then I'll put a heavy acrylic block over the top and allow it to dry. So here's a look at all the shaker tags that I created. This one has a blush and black and white and gold color theme here. And you can see I embossed the sentiment up there that tossed me onto a black piece of cardstock. And here's my multicolored ones, which just scream party to me. As always, I will have links to the featured supplies in the description at YouTube, but head on over to my blog because there you'll find more still shots, more information, a complete list of supplies, and this video is a part of a blog hop, so you'll find the next stop along the hop over on my blog, so be sure to check that out. You're going to find a ton of inspiration along the hop for using this new Essentials by Ellen December 2017 release. So I just adore these shaker tags. I think they scream party. They are so much fun. And like I said, you could put a gift card in there and it would be a really fun way to give a gift card for a birthday or during this holiday season. Thanks for stopping by today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe on YouTube. I really appreciate it. Thanks for stopping by. Thanks for watching. And until next time, I hope you have a fabulous day.